This is CW Iowa Live.
Good morning, everybody. It's 10 minutes past 9 o'clock right now. Welcome back to the program. Lou and Jackie here, along with our good friend Sherry Clark. It is fork in the road time. And first, we need to ask you about how your video series is going.
Oh, my gosh. It's great. I've had a great response to it, and people are just loving it. And we're going to continue it for a little while longer.
We are.
Remind everybody what it's all about.
Okay, so I did a three-part video series, and I did that because I did a survey of people. I had 1,000 people respond. They told me the things that were interesting in their lives and the things that they wanted to upgrade, change, up-level. So I did some training about what those things are. And I'm not going to tip you off onto what it is. It's something that you do want to watch.
All right.
And how do we do that?
What you would do is you'd go to whattheforkareyouwaitingfor.com and sign up there. And that's as easy as it is.
It's
free. Mm-hmm.
Now, I know a lot of times when you do special things like this, they only last for so long. Is there a deadline before people need to get over and check out the videos?
You know, I'm going to leave it up there for a little while longer. I've got some other projects coming up, so I'll leave it up there till I do my next thing. I can't let any moss grow under my feet.
But it's really good, so make sure you go check it out.
Yes, indeed.
Fantastic. Well, I'm so excited you're here because you have broken down literally one of my favorite fruits in the summertime. Watermelon. I love it. Just the smell of it, the taste of it, it's wonderful.
Well, and it's 4th of July, so a lot of times we think about the things that we eat on the 4th of July, and watermelon's one of those. They're not quite 100% in full bore season here in Iowa yet, mm-hmm. but we're getting them from other states, mm-hmm. so let's bring it on, you know? Why not? So what we typically do is we think about eating watermelon, just slicing it up and eating it on
right.
a plate. That's a great way to do it. And I like the kind with the seeds, because I like to spit the seeds when I've done it.
Well, there's seed spitting contest coming up next week, over at Living History
Farms. I like
that,
because there is something about remembering when you were a kid of spitting seeds and doing that, although seedless seems to be kind of the rage right now, so you don't have to worry about that.
I know, but I really like to go for the seeded ones if I can. So there's that. Then the other thing is we usually inject it with vodka and have it as an adult.
Yeah, most people do. Yeah, okay. All right.
Woman after my own heart.
Yeah. So that would not make it a really big health problem. Or health producing thing. So I brought you a little bit of healthier things, and then we're going to go back to the dark side, and I'll show you how to make some fun with it.
So,
if you're ready for that.
So besides just cubing it, eating it, cutting it, we have some really interesting ways of serving it this 4th of July weekend. So what did you bring in for us?
Okay, so think about things that pair well together, and things that pair well with watermelon include lime, blueberry, basil, coconut, all kinds of different things that go well together.
And you said basil, and for some people that haven't seen you before, you said basil, really, with fruit?
Yes, basil and mint both go great with watermelon. I've got something that I'll even prove that with you with. So let's start with a simple one. Let's look at the martini glass.
Martini glass, okay.
And in the martini glass, it's a very simple preparation. It's cubed watermelon, so I took the rind off, and then I made it into little cubes, and you can make them as big or as little as you want.
Okay.
But I wanted to make it into more of an elegant dessert. So I mentioned it pairs well with blueberry. You can see there's a sauce or something on there.
Oh wow, there is at the bottom. Yeah.
Go ahead and give that a little try. And you're going to be surprised because the sauce is something that you're not going to expect it to be. And the sauce is vinegar. The sauce
really?
It's a blueberry balsamic vinegar.
And where does one get blueberry balsamic vinegar?
Well, I have some blueberry balsamic vinegar right here.
So you come to Sherry's house and get it, right?
You come to my house. This I got at Vom Foss. So many of the specialty stores that carry kind of the exotic vinegars and oils, Vom Foss is a great example. It's a slightly sweet balsamic, but it really kind of makes this a little bit more of an elegant, almost a dessert.
Oh, that's delicious.
I would never have thought of that.
Well, that's why I'm here.
That's why she keeps coming back. I love it with the fresh blueberries, but then that just a little bit of vinegar, like you said, and putting it in a glass like this, fantastic presentation.
It just makes it so pretty.
And absolutely delicious. Wow.
So another thing we can do is we can make a soup. So you can see that you've got the small soup bowl, the small soup presentation there. So what I did with that is I used a food processor, and I took some, again, watermelon without the rind, threw it in there, then I added, remember I said lime goes well? Instead of just using lime juice, I used this lime non-dairy yogurt.
Oh, you did?
Yes, because I wanted it to have a creamy consistency.
Give it a little body.
Yes, but I don't eat dairy myself, and so I thought yogurt would be a great addition, but I don't want to use dairy, and many people don't process that well. So I used the lime yogurt so I wouldn't have to use lime juice. Then I add a tiny little pinch of agave because the watermelon wasn't the sweetest, a little grated ginger, and there you have it. So taste that. I've garnished it with some chopped walnuts.
I was gonna say, what's on top?
It's just walnuts.
Just walnuts.
And the reason that I did that again was to give it a little bit more depth, a little bit of body. There's a little bit of fat, and of course, in walnuts, and that gives it more presence.
That's really good.
I really like it. It's a refreshing
soup. It's a dessert, is what it is.
It is refreshing, kind of like a cold soup you would have in the summertime.
Exactly. So we are used to our gazpachos, which are made traditional with tomatoes. Sometimes there's some bell peppers, sometimes jalapeno. But this, I wanted it to be sweeter and lighter, and the kids would like this. Mm-hmm. So once again, remember, I'm always all up your stuff about staying hydrated.
Mm-hmm. And this would hydrate you.
Yes, exactly. So that's a good way to do it.
Now, based on some of your tips from last year, a lot of people had, there was watermelons that were on sale, and we got some big watermelons, and we had one that actually froze. It froze solid, and we're getting ready to throw it away, and you said, no, don't do that. You can take it and you can make things like this, and that's exactly what we did. We can make smoothies out of them, and they are really good.
Exactly. Well, as long as we're freezing things, great segue for me, Lou, because what I did then, I wanted to make something else this morning, and so I was putting together what I was going to bring for you, and I made Jackie a drink. So what I did.
Thank you.
Yeah, she needs that first thing in the morning.
Yes, and you can tell because there's an umbrella in there. That's
right. That makes it fancy, Scott. If you see the umbrella there, yeah.
Yes.
Higher shot. There you go.
There you
fancy.
Go. As Steve Martin said, or Navin Johnson, be somebody.
Well, that's your cue that it's an adult beverage because I put a little umbrella in it. So what I did was I took the leftover soup.
Okay.
I put it in the blender because you don't want a chunky cocktail.
Correct.
That's not really. It's not a great way to go. Doesn't make you popular. I threw in a shot of rum and a little bit of coconut milk and a couple of leaves of basil.
Basil again.
And so now you need to give that a little taste.
This is the kind of smoothie I'm talking about in the morning.
Nobody can't say I'm not liberal.
Oh, that's good.
Isn't that delicious?
That's really good.
Yeah, so use a nice quality of rum. I used a darker rum, and I didn't add a lot because remember, it's watermelon, so it's a high water content. Mm-hmm. So you can't really like dump a whole bunch of rum in there or it'll end up tasting really strong.
Mm-hmm.
But that was just enough to have your little bit of a celebration.
So you're looking like, did for you do like a Myers or an Appleton or something like that?
Mm-hmm, okay. Yep, or Mount Gay would be another good one.
Did you do like a regular shot?
I used one shot.
There you go.
Yep, so, yep. Yep. And I wanted to, there's a little bit left over for everybody else on the set back there. So one shot would be good enough for probably 12, 15 ounces.
You know what my favorite is? The basil that comes through. That is amazing.
I know. It's a surprise. Mm-hmm. You're drinking it and you're thinking this is refreshing and it's sophisticated.
Mm-hmm. It works.
Very tasty.
But again, use watermelon. Again, you need to stay hydrated.
Yes.
And that's one of the fruits that you could use that it's very versatile.
It is very versatile. And it lasts quite a long time. And the other thing is I juice mine a lot. And when I juice it, I don't take the rind off. Throw the rind, the seeds, all of it through the juicer. The key would be to rinse it off first because watermelons grow on the ground. There might be some dirt or some dust left on them. Rinse them off, throw it to the juicer, you'll be so happy. And then if you want to change it up, put some lime in there. And another thing, strawberries. Strawberries go great with watermelon. So strawberry and watermelon juice, oh my gosh.
Really?
Really
and Jackie,
you
said the strawberries are turning out pretty good this year?
Like you said, Sherry, I've had a couple watermelons so far. Not the greatest so far, but they're getting there.
They're getting there.
But the strawberries I've had so far are amazing.
Yep, so go heavier on the strawberries and a little lighter on the watermelon to stretch that out, and you've got a great juice there.
There you go. Now, one other question, when you make your soup like this, do you take the seeds out when we're blending this or not?
I used a seedless on this one.
Seedless watermelon on this one, okay.
I could probably leave the seeds in if I were using a really high-speed blender, but I used a food processor for this, so I would take the seeds out because seeds is, it's one thing if you're gonna spit them off your porch. It's another thing if you're serving it to company as a soup.
And you're spitting at each other.
So, be a little crunchy there. And I love the idea if you have guests over and not everybody enjoys alcoholic beverages to kind of identify which ones are which. So everyone can enjoy this tasty treat.
And without the rum in there, nobody would be the wiser. So you're being a kind host by not pressuring anybody. And if you want to imbibe, by all means do. And if you don't, let's don't.
Some great ideas for the 4th of July or just all summer long.
All right. Well, once again, let's touch on your video series again so people can check out your video series.
Go to whatthefork.com. And then one final thing before I go, remember if you're interested in entering the Iowa State Fair, the time is running out for that. That is July 1st is the deadline. So you're going to want to contact the fair.
Saturday,
It's Saturday. So get on that. It's a great competition that I host. And if you're not interested in my competition, which is primarily raw food, it's all vegan, then look at some of the other ones. There's cinnamon rolls and briskets. And you, if you make it, there's a contest for it.
Mm. That's very, very true. Love it. Thank you, Sherry.
Yeah, great so job welcome. As always.
And remind us the website if we want to check out the video series one more time.
WhatTheForkAreYouWaitingFor.com.
Exactly.
I'm waiting for the commercial so I can eat some more of this soup is what I'm waiting for. It is 21 minutes past 9 o'clock, and this is CW Iowa Live.